Thank you. Hello, my name is Damian Draghici, as he pronounced it, he said it right with a French accent. I'm a member of the European Parliament, and I'm working on Roma projects related to social inclusion and social integration. And I'm here today to talk to you about Roma, their culture, and their history. I'm going to try to speak slower, although I have enough time. So, let me tell you a couple of facts about Roma. Some of them, and very important to you, are those. Most of you know Roma by Roma, Romani, Gitanos in Spain, Kale in Finland or Portugal, Gitan or Manouche in France, and in the UK and Scandinavia, travelers. Most of the places they go, people they call them usually pejoratively gypsies. The main facts about Roma are those. They are originating from India. They have a language, a common language called Romanes. They immigrated through the Balkans in Europe about 1,000 years ago. They, during the World War II, an estimated of 2 million Roma were killed in the concentration camps and to other means of extermination. Up to 19th century, were forced into slavery in most of the Eastern European countries, and in Romania, 500 years of slavery, the longest slavery in the history of humankind. And in Europe, we have right now 12 million Roma, which makes them the largest European Roma minority. I hope those are enough. It's enough information for you about Roma. Now, Roma today, millions of Roma live in isolated slums with no access to water, electricity, struggling to get the health care they need. Lots of Roma live in extreme marginalization, in very poor area, and in the extreme social condition and of economic social conditions. The stereotypes about Roma are everywhere to be found. They've been called, and they are called always, beggars, thieves, criminals, tendency for crimes, and they've been seen as scapegoats. Romani children, it's a particular situation that's worrying, that they are exposed and they are vulnerable. They do not have access to education, poor health, poor nutrition. Also, they are usually they have problems with violence, prostitution, human trafficking. They don't have access to schools, and they are segregated. But the good thing is that the Roma have a human rights movement and a civil society, and they are fighting for anti-discrimination. And this type of human rights movement, they've been educating the young Roma to fight anti-discrimination in every type of field, in institutional and in everyday life. So I want to tell you a Roma tale. And the Roma tale is, says like that, that there was a boy that was born in a very poor family, extreme poverty, and the boy was born in a family of musicians. They've been musicians for the last seven generations from when his great-grandfather was a slave. So, in the family that he grew up, the conditions, they were so horrible that he had to wait for his own brother to come from school in order to borrow his shoes to go himself to school. When he would come from school, his grandmother would feed him for lunch food. A few hours later, she would cover the windows with thick cardboards, in order to get dark in the house and to tell him and his brother that it's already night, and not to ask for food anymore, because they didn't have any food anymore. By the age of 3, he started playing different musical instruments, and by the age of 10, he finally chose his instrument, the pan flute, or pan pipes, as they call it, if you know it, la flauta di pan in Spanish. And by 12, he started working in nightclubs, restaurants, and playing at weddings to support his family. In his early teens, a crazy enough guy, he took a decision. He couldn't stay anymore in Romania to accept the communist regime. He was a very open, outspoken person, a rebel, and a guy that he could not take the totalitarian imposed dictatorialship. So he took a decision to defect the country all by himself, and he crossed the borders illegally through the mountains of Yugoslavia through hostile border checkpoints. So he made it into Greece. Actually, he was aiming for Italy, but he ended up in Greece. The first year in Greece, he was begging in the streets of Greece, and he made a living. He barely made a living. And after that, he got a gig in a nightclub as a keyboard player. A few years later, he applied for Berklee College of Music. He got a full scholarship, and he was off to the United States, where he graduated from Berklee with a magna cum laude, bachelor degree in jazz performance on pamphlet, being the first Roma and Romanian student ever to graduate from Berklee College of Music. After that, he had a huge career. He became an international known artist with releasing 20 albums, having thousands of concerts all around the world, collaborating with people like James Brown, Joe Cocker, Cyndi Lauper, London Symphony Orchestra, Michel Camilo, Chris Botti, Eddie Daniels, Nigel Kennedy, and performing on Grammy-winning albums. And at a certain moment, after he reached all his dreams, he realized that he wanted to contribute back to his people, to the Roma people. So he went back to his roots, and he put together a band of his own brothers, the Gypsy Brothers, a band of 18 people. And he started promoting in Europe the band. And the main mission of the band was to go against the stereotypes that people have about Roma and the prejudice. They have about 655 concerts in 3 years, and that got him a nomination as the European ambassador of European Roma. Later, he decided that he wanted to help the Roma people. So in about 5 years ago, when Nicolas Sarkozy started evicting and deporting Roma people from France, he took a stand and he started fighting for his people. So he had a foundation where he started helping 1,000 kids to learn music, and he had a program called Social Education through Music Programs and Social Inclusion. And that program educated thousands of kids with food, clothes, teachers, instruments. Most of the kids won, all of them won huge results and won awards all over the world. After that, he realized that he could not do enough within the civil society, so he went he got nominated as the Prime Minister State Councillor of Romania, and 6 months later, he ran for a seat in the Senate of Romania, and he won a four-year term. That's when he realized that he could not do enough for his people from a national standpoint, so he went to get elected for the European Parliament, and he won the election to the European Parliament. That boy is me, and that's my life story. I'm Damian Drăghici, and that's my life story. So I'm still a Roma, as you can see. I never give up. Now, let me tell you one important thing. The Roma culture, as you know, Roma culture is flourishing, and it's been flourishing for many, many years. And most of you know us just for dancing and music, and seeing us very happy. But we've been to a lot of struggle and a lot of persecution, and somehow all that pain made us keep our music inside of us with a lot of passion and a lot of crazy rhythms, a lot of Andalusian flamenco and Romanian gypsy music. In the last 200, 300 years, very famous composers, writers, and painters got influenced by the Roma culture. Composers such as Liszt, Brahms, Rachmaninoff, Bartok, De Falla, writers such as Federico Garcia Lorca, Gabriel Garcia Marquez, Picasso, Renoir, Matisse. So many famous people, Roma people, it says that they have Romani blood, such as people like Pablo Picasso, Mother Teresa, Charlie Chaplin, Ava Gardner, Rita Hayworth, Django Reinhardt, and Yul Brynner. I hope one day, that's my hope, that Romani culture is going to be recognized, and finally we're going to get recognized that we had an impact in the world culture. Now, What is my mission in the European Parliament and what do I want to accomplish? First of all, I'm going to fight for my people, for the Roma people. I'm going to fight against discrimination. I will fight against anti-Gypsyism. And also, I will make sure that every European institution, every European country will join me on promoting human rights perspective and EU Roma citizenship and equality. The second one, it's very important for me, the social inclusion of the Roma. For the last 25 years, the social inclusion was taking in the wrong steps and the wrong approach. It's been sectorial. I've been developing a concept in the last years called FEPSD, the four equal pillars of social development. What I'm talking about here is that education, housing, health and employment, they are equally important for a person that doesn't have nothing to eat. You cannot go to school on an empty stomach. You cannot go to school or to work without clothes. You cannot pay for your rent if you don't have work. And you cannot go to a doctor if you don't have insurance. So basically the idea is not mine. I got influenced by the pyramid of Maslow and the first two layers, which is the physiological and the safety. So if you do not have those two, you cannot go towards self-actualization. Most of you know that. My intention is that I want social inclusion for my people. And social inclusion, I define it like that. A place where people, they can live in a community. You are respected by your peers. You, in exchange, give your culture and traditions. And all can live in peace. And all can live in dignity. So I hope that all of the above that I told you, I will be able to fight and to be the one to have a critical role for a Europe free of discrimination, stigma, and to have the Roma well-educated, empowered, and for the future generation, Roma, they can have kids of educated Roma, good citizens, workers, and above all, good human beings. Thank you so much.